Can you inadvertently damage the penile or cavernous nerves? Many men are worried about exactly that, especially men with erectile problems. Did they make a mistake? Masturbate? Here's the twist. As a specialist in penile health, I don't believe nerve damage is the main cause for most cases. In fact, there are mainly two situations where the risk is real, and I'll cover both in this video. And if you do fall into one of these categories, don't give up. Some nerve damage can improve, and even if you can't bring it back to 100%, there's still a lot we can do to make things work again. Picture it like this. The lights in your living room don't turn on. You flip the switch again and again, nothing. Most people assume the bulb is dead. But what if the problem is in the wiring? And what if that wiring could be fixed, rerouted, or replaced? That's what we're talking about today. Nerve damage and erectile dysfunction. It's far more common than most men have been told, but far less common than many fear. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. Stick with me, because over the next few minutes, you'll hear things most men never get from their doctors. Many of you watching think ED is only about blood flow or testosterone. That's the story we've been sold. But nerve damage? That's the hidden player, and for some men, the real root cause. Before we dive into causes, subscribe, like, and hype, and let's keep one thing clear in your mind. Improvement is possible. Complete recovery, rare but real in select cases. Partial recovery, much more common, and for many men, enough to bring back a satisfying sex life. So, how does it work? Think of your brain as the light switch, your penis as the bulb, and your nerves as the wiring. The command travels from your brain down your spinal cord into the pelvic plexus, then along the cavernous nerves, the final stretch before the light turns on. Damage anywhere along this path disrupts the signal. No signal, no erection. But damage doesn't always mean dead. In a moment, I'll tell you the number one cause of nerve-related ED and why so many men miss the warning signs. Number one cause? Diabetes-induced polyneuropathy. About a quarter of men over 55 have diabetes. Half of them develop nerve damage. Half of those get ED. That's roughly 6% of all men in your age group dealing with nerve damage from diabetes that affects their sex life. Here's the part that hooks back to you. Ever had numb feet, tingling hands, or burning in your legs at night? That same process is attacking the tiny nerve fibers that control erections. And here's the catch. You might notice the bedroom effects last long after other signs have been ignored. High blood sugar is like battery acid on wiring. The smallest, most delicate fibers are the first to fail. The earlier you control glucose, the more signal you preserve. What can you do? Monitor your blood sugar. Get your A1C checked at least twice a year. Control your diet. Less sugar, more fiber, healthier fats. Exercise regularly to improve both blood flow and nerve health. Ask your doctor about nerve-focused therapies, alpha lipoic acid, certain medications, and yes, even regenerative techniques like shockwave or PRP. Now the second big cause, radical prostatectomy for cancer. Those cavernous nerves I mentioned, they run right along the prostate. Even the most skilled surgeon can't always avoid trauma. Right after surgery, 50 to 80% of men have ED. 2 years later, 30 to 50% still do. That's about 2% of all men over 55 living with this particular problem. Here's the loop. Nerves heal slowly. I've seen men regain function 12, 18, even 24 months later, but only if they work at it. That means using medications, devices, rehab exercises, and in my practice, procedures like shockwave therapy and platelet-rich plasma. Pelvic floor training, vacuum therapy, daily low-dose PDE5 inhibitors, all part of the rehab toolbox. The sooner you start, the better the odds. Waiting 6 months or a year before acting can mean losing ground you can't get back. Haven't subscribed yet? Here's your chance. Subscribe now so you don't miss my upcoming videos. Now, let's widen the lens. Other causes exist, less common but real, alcohol-related neuropathy from years of heavy drinking, spine problems like herniated discs or spinal stenosis pinching pelvic nerve roots, pelvic surgeries beyond the prostate, bladder removal, rectal surgery, major vascular repairs, all put delicate nerves at risk. Radiation therapy for prostate, bladder, or rectum can scar nerves over time. Neurological diseases like Parkinson's and MS disrupt signal pathways. Rare infections, shingles in the pelvic region, untreated Lyme disease can leave lasting damage. Even mechanical trauma from extreme cycling or overuse of vacuum pumps plays a role. One word on pumps. They are very safe to use, but under certain circumstances, they can cause problems if misused. Video link at the end. Why do these causes get missed? Because most men and many doctors focus only on blood flow or hormones. Nerve-related ED often develops gradually, making cause and effect harder to connect. And men rarely link tingling feet, back pain, or pelvic surgery scars to bedroom problems. So here's my challenge to you. If you've had any of these issues in your medical history, think about whether your sexual health changed afterwards. That connection might be the missing piece. Here's the reality check. Full restoration is rare. Partial improvement? Often possible. And with the right tools, PDE5 inhibitors, mechanical aids, rehab protocols, even surgery, you can bypass or reroute the damaged pathway. Sometimes it's not about fixing the original wiring, but creating a detour that works just as well. Loop back to hope. You're not stuck unless you give up. Men who take action, try different approaches, and stay consistent often surprise themselves with the results. If you learned something today, share this video with a friend who might need it. You could change his life. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched. This content simplifies complex physiological relationships and is for educational purposes only. It is not a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment.